Hi everybody, it's your regular girl, and I'm not showing my face today because I was going to stop making these because the sight of my face is just, I just can't handle it. It does say something for the face washing routine that I had going on and the cosmetics that I was using because it seems like they were pretty good. But I have not been able to do that in the same ritualistic way that I was able to do before I went into the hospital recently. So it's just, I just can't stand looking at my face in the video anymore. So anyway, where I'm sitting is as close to these trees as I can get to. This morning, I've come to have some coffee, and this is that place that I like to go to called Crosswalk or Crossroads. I still cannot remember. Maybe I'll scoot on down here and see what the name of it is and get it was right. Right who was. Yeah, see, I'm thinking there was something that went on with my brain this last time. And I'm still waiting for the referral for a neurologist. It's been a month since I've been out of the hospital. They took some tests for my brain as soon as I got there and would not give me the results. What kind of a medical system is this? Not a good one, is what I'm saying. Not a good one. So if I were married, or if I had a significant other, would they have given the results to that person? I don't know, but I had to sign a release at Crosswalk, is what it's called. Crosswalk is called Crosswalk. Okay. What's the Crosswalk? Number one starts here. All this artwork is done by somebody named Chris Erickson. And it has such an impact on me that I wrote to him, telling him so. It's not a very long letter. But he ended up sending me two of his books. One of them is Say Yes, and the other is Honest Advent. I would love the one on prayer, by the way, Scott, if you're watching this. Because that's what I keep thinking about. So no, here's number one. What I loved about these, because I'm used to this, now I can't even think of what the name of this is. It's the Stations of the Cross, that's what it was. So that's how it started off. It's an exhibit that was the Stations of the Cross, and we met here, a small group of people met here. Anybody who wanted to come, we had bread afterwards. And somebody played the guitar, sang some songs, paused, we did the Stations of the Cross, but I had never seen artwork like this, representational of Stations of the Cross. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I still love it. This is number two, Jesus is Betrayed. And then with each one, there is a biblical scripture. So after I saw it the first time, I asked the ministers of this church, like, who said, let's do this? This is fabulous. And who is this artist? Do you know him? So Rob Burks gave me the name of him once again, said no, you know, and told me a little bit about how the exhibit came to be and that they decided to keep it up. Which I think is fabulous, but I come here like, I would say like 5 out of 7 days of the week, I come down here. There's a coffee stand around the corner. This is number four. And there's certain of these, ones of these that have really gotten my attention and lasted with me through the week. And I've had like sort of certain experiences with them throughout the week where they impact my life. Synchro mystical events is what I have come to call them. Jesus is given his cross. Maybe this is the one for today, because this got my attention yesterday. This is John 3:14-15. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the desert, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. I should be focusing this. See, I'm not a very good video maker. But go to, you're here on YouTube, go look up Scott Erickson and look at what he says about what it is that he's doing. with his art, his story. He tells it briefly, even though that's what his book is about. So you don't have to buy the book to hear his story about himself, his bio as an artist. And this is what has culminated now. This is where he's at now, kind of present day, with his artwork. He's a really prince, I guess is what you call him. Jesus Falls. This is one of the first ones that got me. Unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed, but if it dies, it produces many seeds. This was fascinating to me one day. It kept with me throughout the week. It's fascinating because I didn't quite understand it all the way. A lot of these I didn't understand all the way. This is very cool. This happens in the story of Jesus carrying his own cross on the way to getting crucified. Simon carries Jesus' cross. There's somebody named Simon who was significant in Jesus' life, and he ends up carrying his cross for a bit. If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Matthew 16:24. And then here's the picture. See? You're different than most of the artwork that I've ever seen for Stations of the Cross, and I absolutely fucking love it. I guess I didn't have to say that fucking word. I did for emphasis. But yesterday, this one got me. For if men do these things when the tree is green, what will happen when it is dry? This is Luke 23:31. I really did not understand this one at all. So I'll just tell you quickly what Scott says about this artwork in connection with the scripture. He said these pictures are not pictures of the scripture. They're not meant to be that. They're completely different. It's a different language. Artwork is a different language. So it's not like the picture is not depicting the scripture. It's a different language for prayer. So tools for prayer. Prayer is not just the mechanics, so it's not just the tools we need for the prayer, it's the essence, and the essence is something else, that's something that's within us. Jesus is nailed to the cross. My God, why have you forsaken me? Matthew 27:46. As I was looking at this one yesterday, I was thinking, you know, this is what I think that maybe most people can relate to, is this essence, this feeling, this sensation. It's one, it's the one for me. So this is really interesting. See what's coming out. One of the reasons I love this cross walk is that sometimes isn't too long. But when does Jesus die? This is John 15:13. Usually people are just walking from here. I'm in the only one I've ever seen doing this. Pausing and hanging out. And then Jesus is buried. So the scripture with this is Matthew 26:12. When she poured this perfume on her body, she did it to prepare me. Jesus rises. Look at this, see? He's live, alive. And one of the things in ministry I'm grateful about is the setting in which it's going. Which over here to the right, there's these absolutely gorgeous trees. And it creates this shaded. It's just amazing to me because right down there, down the trees is University Avenue. It's a really busy street. So it's really kind of amazing what these trees do, these row of trees, how they protect and they create this aura of peace over here. It's amazing how much peace they create. So that's what I come down here for every day. street on the right side of here is something called Mission Brew Coffee. All kinds of coffee drinks. What is it from the skater? This reminds me of my father. Nice. Remembering even though. Even though. Kinds of coffee drinks and a couple of interesting little food snacks, sandwiches and stuff if you need that, but it's this, the green. He's a passing one, so this morning, realizing this is really well here for the communication guide to trees we're doing here. And I want to tell you all what was going on with the videos. I've listened to some really interesting podcasts in the last couple of days. That's probably what I would be talking about. I want to tell you why I stopped making those videos, and this is how the videos are changing. Maybe I just won't show my face for a while or something. There's other things to film, you know. She didn't care. This is a whole new art form anyway. This podcast, live streaming things. Need the live streaming things. I'll tell you one thing right off the top of my head that was really interesting was Joe Rogan interviewing two other people, so it was three of them talking, but two other people who had been incarcerated, one guy for the first time, and they talk about what it's really like inside. Fabulous. What I said in the comments was, thank you for doing this interview. We've needed to hear this for decades. We've needed to be able to hear what it's really like inside for decades, because that's how that system stays so corrupt, is that nobody's allowed to talk about it. And it could be, if you wanted to be, it does warrant it with the kind of things we've seen happen, being a little concerned for Joe Rogan and the other two people. In fact, in one of the comments, there was a comment that concerned me about somebody looking for one of these guys. So they had tremendous courage to do this. And then there was another Joe Rogan where there was a guy who was incarcerated in Russia. And he talks about the details of what happened to him and what it was like. Yeah, that's something that's interesting too, because prisons are a prison, and it was very similar. The prison in Russia was very similar to the prison in the United States. So, you know, who's fooling who? This nonsense about, you know, the bad Chinese, the bad Russians. Prison is prison. And it's a dysfunctional system, and it is extremely corrupt. And I don't know why, for decades, they've gotten to film us as we're going in and out. And our cell phones were taken away, and we could not tell anybody about what really happened inside there. It occurred to me, hey, you know what? That was even one of my original podcasts, was the Orange Jumpsuit Show. We got the wrong people in the orange jumpsuits, you know? And I remember at that time, 2012, there was talk about careful women. What you're focusing on, because that's how you end up. I ended up choosing this name, a regular girl, and focusing on that, picking that name, and then if we take a look at the direction that my life went in, it's like, whoa indeed. Well, it's a good thing that I do love Jesus, meaning like, yes, I was a student of what maybe, for lack of a better term, for lack of any other term, we call them the Ascended Masters. Jesus is certainly one of them, if not a top dog. Anyway, you know, any fool can see if you're going to be a student of someone, you're going to learn to do the things they do. And you take a look at what he did in his life, and maybe you're going to say, you know what, I'm not so sure I want to do that. Instead of know, the kind of life where I'm the center of attention and I'm doing something that people wish they could do and creating beauty, I've become like I can't do that anymore. I can't do any of those things anymore the way that I could. And I do indeed become very ordinary. But it turns out, see, to Jesus, that doesn't matter. To God, it doesn't matter if I'm ordinary. God is for everybody. The drooling, ugly teeth and all that. Not that I can't be made into something beautiful,
okay,
but,
did you watch the hockey?
You know, well, it is a Saturday morning, so I'm just going to be going for 15 minutes.